But this is the story that has me fired up tonight, and this story will touch every community across this country. People are desperate for all kinds of help across America. Yesterday, it was tens of thousands of people looking for housing help in Georgia. Today, I attended a rally of professional Americans who have been displaced by corporate greed and out-of-touch politicians. A passionate crowd of 99ers rallied at the Federal Hall here in New York. In the shadow of Wall Street. They had one basic question: where are the jobs?
I want to be working again, but where are the jobs?
Where are the jobs?
These are average working class Americans who want Washington to wake up and hear what they have to say.
To all the people out there who believe that we're sitting on the couch all day long drinking beer and watching television, we're not. We're actively looking for work. We're actively looking for jobs that are not there. And I'm at my wit's end. I don't know what more I can do.
What would you say to President Obama if you had a chance to talk to him?
I know exactly what I would say to President Obama. I would tell him today, you actually have the legal power to sign an executive order for an emergency or crisis. This is a crisis. I don't have money to buy food. By November, I have no more money from my savings to pay for my rent. If people can be helped in Afghanistan and people can be helped in Haiti, why aren't the American people considered a crisis?
If you had a chance to talk to President Obama, what would you say?
I would say, don't forget us. We're out here.
Do you think he has?
I think that we're not exactly at the top of his list. We're on the list somewhere, but we're not a priority.
I know he's doing the best he can, but things are a mess right now. It's hard, but I would just say, Obama, please help the people. Help the people get more extension. More Niners out here. It's a big turnout today. They need help.
Both those gentlemen were professional people that actually worked on Wall Street and worked in companies. And they, of course, were downsized and knocked out of the economy. And they've been out of the economy for several years. What are we supposed to do, Republicans? I'd like to tell these people that Washington is listening. But the reality is members of Congress are back home trying to save their own jobs. You could see the passion in the eyes of the 99ers today. They just want a chance to work. That's it. There's no magic to this stuff. But keep in mind, the Republican Party has fought every jobs bill, every unemployment bill, and every social safety net that the 99ers have looked for and all Americans need. Republicans care about the people inside those buildings on Wall Street. They don't give a damn about the middle class or the folks who are out of work. Americans need a break right now. Meanwhile, today, people in East Point, Georgia, returned applications for public-assisted housing. The unemployment rate in Fulton County, where East Point is located, is 10.8%. The pictures of these Americans swarming officials should be all the wake-up call the Congress needs when it comes to the question being answered, where in the hell is our country going? Do we care? Do we have a moral compass anymore? The Republican Party has been on a crusade against the middle class and the poor for the last 30 years. We're now seeing the wreckage of that race to the bottom line culture. The president knows how important unemployment and housing and how that problem is and how it's got to be addressed. So today, his administration announced that it will spend about another $3 billion to help unemployed people pay their mortgages. That's a great step forward. California is going to get $476 million. Florida, $239 million. Illinois, $166 million. Ohio, $149 million. And the state of Georgia will get $127 million in help when it comes to housing. These are the areas that have been hit hard. Now, I would like to see Republican Senators Johnny Isaacson and Saxmas Chamley meet with these 30,000 constituents that you just saw on videotape in East Point, look them in the eyes, and tell them that they voted against unemployment benefits. The picture is getting worse. Today, a government report showed weekly jobless claims at a five-month high. 484,000 new unemployment claims were filed in the week ending August 7th. And you know what, folks? You can lay this right at the feet, right at the altar. Let's genuflect now. Right at the altar of the Republican Party, who blocked a $30 billion small business bill not long ago. Republican obstructionism is absolutely tearing this country apart at the seams. It's dividing America. The people you see flooding the streets, begging for help, begging for an opportunity, are victims of the Republican agenda just to make sure that President Obama fails and doesn't have any success. I do believe that when the Republicans not long ago blocked money to community banks for small businesses to be able to get credit and get access to capital to go out and do business in this country, I think that set the tone to strangle this economic recovery for months to come. It was the most un-American thing the Republican Party has ever done. What do you have against small business? What do you have against giving someone an opportunity? Now, on one hand, the Republicans, they say no to the 99ers. They say no to more unemployment benefits. And then on the other hand, they say, well, no, we can't help out small business either. I'd like the Republican Party to stand up and say, whose side are you on? They're not on anybody's side, folks. All they want to do is see President Obama fail. They don't like the fact that someone who cares about people is in the White House. And someone who actually did something about health care in this country that's going to save lives, that party's going to get the credit for it. So there's going to be more lies spewed about our economy between now and November, more obstruction than you've ever seen before. And this is going to be gut check time for the Democrats and for the progressives who have been squabbling for the last few days. How much do we really care about one another? Can we come together as a people and pull this country out of the hole? It's going to take a hell of a lot of leadership, but it's unfortunate that this recess is taking place now when this country needs leadership at this dire hour.